We see Oleg Kononenko there. He's the outgoing Expedition 59 commander. He's going to be the Soyuz commander in the center seat. There's NASA astronaut Anne McClain. She's going to be in the right seat. And then just now into view, that's David Saint-Jacques, outgoing Canadian astronaut, wrapping up his first space flight. Now we're going to see some of the crew members remaining on board. First one is Alexei Ovchinin. He's now going to be the Expedition 60 commander remaining on board. And there's Nick Haig and Christina Cook, who are also going to be remaining on board. Both NASA astronauts on their first flights. They're going to remain on board for Expedition 60, and Christina Cook actually going to remain for additional expeditions as her stay was lengthened. She'll actually be staying on board until February 2020, coming home with a different crew.
That's great. Looks great. Yes, we see you. You said your farewells. Everything looks good. Alexei. This is Aydar speaking. Don't forget about the KSD cap. Yeah, I took it off personally and gave it to Oleg. Copy. Thank you.
And we see the hatch now closed on the Soyuz side.
And I will start closing my side. Okay, go ahead.
And Alexei Ovchinin now moving in to close the hatch on the station side. Getting treated to some really great views right now. That is our Soyuz spacecraft that we're waiting to undock from the Poisk module. You can see some very mountainous areas in the background as it just completed a pass over Nepal, currently flying out over central China right now.
Separation is confirmed. Alexei, Nick.
And physical separation
Christina,
confirmed.
Bye-bye. See you soon, guys. Soft landing, guys. Godspeed. We'll see you back on Earth. Copy, guys. We'll see you back on Earth. Please monitor all the parameters. Yes, copy.
So the Soyuz beginning to back away. That undocking coming at 6:25 p.m. Central Time, 7:25 p.m. Eastern. At the moment of undocking, the station was flying 256 statute miles over Eastern Mongolia. And it's going to continue backing away for a couple of minutes. They'll execute that first separation burn in just about a minute from now. That'll be just a quick 8-second burn to begin taking the Soyuz even further away from the station.
2 minutes after the separation. Copy.
Five seconds. We have DPO activation. Issue. The 4 should not be issued at this time, E1 at this time.
And there it is. So there's the Soyuz spacecraft. You're going to see some white smoke coming out. That's actually excess hydrogen peroxide being vented from onboard the spacecraft. It's rare that we get a sight of it this early to even see that event, but pretty great conditions out there for the teams on the ground able to get a shot of it. And you see that puff of smoke? That means the soft landing engines have fired. Oleg, Kononenko, David, Saint-Jacques, and McClain back on planet Earth.
And we are starting to see the crew members come out right now. You may actually have a better view than me, but it looks like it's Oleg, Kononenko first, which is usually the case for the commander.
Yep, it looks like Oleg's first down, and he's going to make his way down this slide here. About how far is it, would you say, between here and those chairs where they're going to get carried over to?
Oh, like 15 feet probably. Not far at all. And here's Ann McClain waving to the crowd, waving her fist to the crowd. Looking very excited to be back on Earth and getting a round of applause and response.
And I think we have a few of Anne's friends and family here in Mission Control Houston hearing some cheers from our viewing gallery as Astro Animal makes her way out of the capsule.
Yes, some water.
Again, this was Anne's first space flight, 204 days in space. That's a heck of a duration for a first flight.
She looks like she came through well. She looks like she's feeling pretty good right now.
Over here towards me. Lift her higher.
All right, well, it's great to see Anne McClain back on the ground. Definitely looking like she enjoyed the ride back home. Again, wrapping up her first space flight. We're getting a shot now of the commander. This is also a chance for the crew members to speak to some of their family members via sat phone once they've reached back down here on the ground.
And here comes David, pulling him out now. Also getting a round of applause and giving a thumbs up to the crowd. Because they're helping him down now.
And so now you're just starting to see the crew members get carried one at a time. We'll see a group of people gather around the chairs and carry them over again to that medical tent. It's a big orange inflatable tent set up there on the ground in Kazakhstan where they're able to get them out of those Sokol launch and entry suits, change into flight suits for the helicopter ride back. Again, that'll be about a two-hour flight back to the main staging airport in Karaganda. Where both a plane for Oleg Kononenko is waiting to bring him and the Roscosmos contingent back to the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Center. The NASA plane standing by to bring Anne McClain and David Saint-Jacques back here to Houston.
Сто девятнадцать восемьдесят.